Emily's daughter would be like, "Can I have a cheeky little Freddo?" It's just like any like
cheeky little
yes,
Freddo.
I'll give you anything you want, you adorable child.
Well, it's a real pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
One other thing I want to start with. So, Michael and Jane, obviously, they don't really believe when they're adults that this has all happened to them. And then suddenly they go, oh, actually, this was real. So I want to know what's been the most surreal moment of your life.
The most surreal moment of my life? Honestly, every day on the set of this film was pretty surreal, you know? From the moment we walked onto Cherry Tree Lane, which looks exactly as it did in the original, to Dancing with Penguins, to Dancing with Meryl Streep, to climbing Big Ben, the set of skills you have to master to be in this movie. That's sort of the fun of making a movie. It's different from doing a show. Doing a piece of theater is like a yoga. You're going to hit the same spots every night, but the audience is different, and your cast may feel different. But when you make a movie, every day is this weird new adventure.
Is that the kind of the strange thing for you, that you almost want to like go into the cinemas and watch people watching to see their reactions? Because I guess you're so used to experiencing that on stage.
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like we've been sitting on a secret for a year and a half, and I like to go, whenever we have a Q&A after screenings, I go to the screenings and I watch the movie, because it's glorious to hear sort of the applause and the gasps. I mean, it's just been wonderful.
And I went I ended up doing like a cry counter on my notebook.
How'd you do?
I think I cried probably 2 times and welled up about 5, which is a lot for me in a movie. I'm not normally, and it's mostly like happy tears. That's the thing.
That's the beautiful thing, yeah.
There's so many just wonderful moments. Are you a bit of a happy cryer? Are you the kind of person that...
I'm a totally happy cryer. You catch me at the right dog food commercial and I'm happy crying. I watch those YouTubes of like, soldiers coming home and being greeted by their dogs. You know, it really doesn't take much.
Property programs for me, like a house renovation a needy family. I'm like, oh my
god. Oh yeah,
I could be watching it for 3 minutes and I'll be in tears. And I'm like, are you okay? What's going on? Obviously, you do get to dance with penguins. Penguins are like apparently it's my patronus. If I could have a patronus,
really?
It would be a penguin, I think. Yeah, I kind of am a bit flappy. What would yours be?
I'm a bit flappy. That's a good question. I always used to joke that it was my friend Karen Olivo just yelling at whatever was bothering me until they went away. She was my co-star in The Heights. And yeah, it's Karen Olivo just being like, leave him alone. that's what I picture.
Mary Poppins was the first movie I ever had on VHS. What was the first film you ever owned?
Oh, that's interesting. We owned it as well on VHS, and I remember, it had sort of the fluffy white box. The Disney boxes were a little bigger than the others. But the one I remember going out and buying was Little Mermaid. In fact, I remember calling in sick from school so that I could get it at 9 a.m. I didn't want to wait till the end of the school day, so I faked a fever, put my head up against a radiator, faked a fever so that I could be the first to have it.
Oh, my God. That's real dedication.
Yeah.
What's the those of lots of impressive things that happen this? What is your most impressive like party trick? What's your sort of go-to thing to impress people?
Oh, every party trick that I can do, I worked into my choreography in this film. So I've been getting in trouble for sliding down banisters on my butt since I was a little kid in elementary school. That's in the movie. I can balance any kind of stick on my feet for like very long periods of time. Yeah, I used to practice with like those balloons you'd buy like at the hospital or in the drugstore. I would just do that for hours, and I could do it with rulers. And so I do that with a flaming stick during Triple Little Light Fantastic, and it made it into the movie. So I try to utilize all my party tricks.
Any mistakes in the takes? Any times where things nearly caught on
fire? It fell many of times. Luckily, it didn't fall on me.
Okay.
But tons of mistakes all the time.
You obviously got to live here in the UK. What's maybe the things that you've discovered about here that surprised you?
You guys have the best candy in the world. Butterscotch treats, dib dabs, chocolate frogs, flying saucers, which really taste like... It sort of tastes exactly like Catholic wafers with tang inside them.
Who introduced you to them all? Was it that you went? You took yourself to
craft
the shop?
Craft services on set, and then when our kids would come, it was like hiding. But Emily will tell you the same thing. It was like the ADs are like sneaking. What did she call them? Emily's daughter would be like, "Oh, I have a cheeky little Freddo."
No, she didn't say
it's just like any
a
like
cheeky little
yes,
Freddo.
I'll give you anything you want, you adorable child. So yeah, it was sort of both our kids sort of sneaking whatever candies they could on set.
Where did she pick up cheeky little Freddo?
I think one of the ADs said it. Would you like a little cheeky little Freddo? And so that became the phrase. It was not a Freddo. It was a cheeky little Freddo.
It's a cheeky one. They've gone up dramatically in price. It's very sad for us all. Anyway, yeah. I've run out of time, but thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Cheers.
Thank you.